Oogenesis, Wikipedia article audio. Oogenesis, ovogenesis, or oogenesis/o. DNSS/ is the differentiation of the ovum into a cell competent to further development when fertilized. It is developed from the primary oocyte by maturation. Oogenesis in mammals. The creation of oogonia. Human oogenesis. Oogenesis. Number of primary oocytes. Oogenesis. Meiosis I. Meiosis II. Folliculogenesis. Maturation into ovum. In vitro maturation. Oogenesis in non-mammals. In mammals, the first part of oogenesis starts in the germinal epithelium, which gives rise to the development of ovarian follicles, the functional unit of the ovary. Oogenesis consists of several sub-processes: oocytogenesis, oogenesis, and finally maturation to form an ovum. Folliculogenesis is a separate sub-process that accompanies and supports all three oogenetic sub-processes. Oogonium primary oocyte first polar body and secondary oocyte second polar body and ovum. Oocyte meiosis, important to all animal life cycles yet unlike all other instances of animal cell division, occurs completely without the aid of spindle-coordinating centrosomes. The creation of oogonia traditionally doesn't belong to oogenesis proper, but, instead, to the common process of gametogenesis, which, in the female human, begins with the processes of folliculogenesis, oocytogenesis, and oogenesis. Oogenesis starts with the process of developing primary oocytes, which occurs via the transformation of oogonia into primary oocytes, a process called oocytogenesis. Oocytogenesis is complete either before or shortly after birth. It is commonly believed that, when oocytogenesis is complete, no additional primary oocytes are created, in contrast to the male process of spermatogenesis, where gametocytes are continuously created. In other words, primary oocytes reach their maximum development at 20 weeks of gestational age, when approximately 7 million primary oocytes have been created. However, at birth, this number has already been reduced to approximately 1 to 2 million. Recently, however, two publications have challenged the belief that a finite number of oocytes are set around the time of birth. The renewal of ovarian follicles from germline stem cells has been reported in the postnatal mouse ovary. In contrast, DNA clock measurements do not indicate ongoing oogenesis during human females' lifetimes. Thus, further experiments are required to determine the true dynamics of small follicle formation. The succeeding phase of oogenesis occurs when the primary oocyte develops into an oogonid. This is achieved by the process of meiosis. In fact, a primary oocyte is, by its biological definition, a cell whose primary function is to divide by the process of meiosis. However, although this process begins at prenatal age, it stops at prophase I. In late fetal life, all oocytes, still primary oocytes, have halted at this stage of development, called the dictyate. After menarche, these cells then continue to develop, although only a few do so every menstrual cycle. Meiosis I of oogenesis begins during embryonic development, but halts in the diplotene stage of prophase I until puberty. The mouse oocyte in the dictyate stage actively repairs DNA damage, whereas DNA repair is not detectable in the pre-dictyate stages of meiosis. For those primary oocytes that continue to develop in each menstrual cycle, however, synapsis occurs and tetrads form, enabling chromosomal crossover to occur. As a result of meiosis I, the primary oocyte has now developed into the secondary oocyte and the first polar body. Immediately after meiosis I, the haploid secondary oocyte initiates meiosis II. However, this process is also halted at the metaphase II stage until fertilization, if such should ever occur. When meiosis II has completed, an oocyte and another polar body have now been created. Synchronously with oocytogenesis, the ovarian follicle surrounding the oocyte has developed from a primordial follicle to a preovulatory one. Both polar bodies disintegrate at the end of meiosis II, leaving only the oocyte, which then eventually undergoes maturation into a mature ovum. The function of forming polar bodies is to discard the extra haploid sets of chromosomes that have resulted as a consequence of meiosis. In vitro maturation is the technique of letting ovarian follicles mature in vitro. It can potentially be performed before an IVF. In such cases, ovarian hyperstimulation isn't essential. Rather, oocytes can mature outside the body prior to IVF. Hence, no gonadotropins have to be injected in the body. Immature eggs have been grown until maturation in vitro at a 10% survival rate, but the technique is not yet clinically available. With this technique, cryopreserved ovarian tissue could possibly be used to make oocytes that can directly undergo in vitro fertilization. Some algae and the oomycetes produce eggs in oogonia. In the brown alga fucus, all four egg cells survive oogenesis, which is an exception to the rule that generally only one product of female meiosis survives to maturity. In plants, oogenesis occurs inside the female gametophyte via mitosis. In many plants such as bryophytes, ferns, and gymnosperms, egg cells are formed in archegonia. In flowering plants, the female gametophyte has been reduced to an 8-celled embryo sac within the ovule inside the ovary of the flower. Oogenesis occurs within the embryo sac and leads to the formation of a single egg cell per ovule. In Ascaris, the oocyte does not even begin meiosis until the sperm touches it, in contrast to mammals, where meiosis is completed in the estrus cycle.